Hello and welcome to Rod's Tabletop Hoops. The moment has arrived to try out this brand new game called Bankshot Basketball. I've got two teams at halftime. The 72 UCLA Bruins are playing the 1979 Michigan State Spartans. Stars of the team, of course, are Bill Walton for UCLA, who had an impressive seven block shots in the first half. And Magic Johnson for Michigan State, who's had kind of a mediocre game so far. And Michigan State is struggling with some foul difficulties. Both Greg Kelser and Vincent. I think Kelser has three fouls. Vincent has two. Ron Charles has three. And in college, you only get five before a disqualification occurs. So we're going to try this game out early in the second half, see if these guys can stay in the game without fouls. A lot of these teams in college basketball just don't have a lot of depth. So I see about one player per team that has a lot of depth. So here we go. I was going to start also by saying I'm getting a lot of positive feedback on a prior video that I did, the one titled Discussion Accuracy versus Realism in Tabletop Hoops Games. Appreciate all of that feedback. I was going to read my favorite piece of feedback. It's from Larry. And he basically says, I think the term quote-unquote accuracy can be a tricky one in this hobby. Perhaps relative accuracy versus precision is needed. And so that's what the that's really rung a bell with me, because I was kind of raised on games that were super accurate. Fast break basketball was so accurate that it kind of set the bar pretty high for me. But I've also understood over time, especially since I've started this channel and started the Tabletop Basketball Games board games group on Facebook, that a lot of people play the game, and the emphasis on fun exceeds the accuracy part, because the games are just fun to play, which makes a total bunch of sense. And I can see that, especially with Status Pro Basketball. The game sometimes doesn't have the greatest accuracy, but it also has a great fun factor and is loved by many in our hobby. So I was just going to point that out. I thank Larry for that comment. And I think based on a lot of the feedback I'm getting, it's changing my view of a lot of basketball games. They don't necessarily have to be totally accurate. They can be relatively precise or relatively accurate and still be great basketball simulations. Well, we've got a game here called Bankshot Basketball, and I'm still determining whether the accuracy and fun factors, where they fit on the scale. And I've played just one half of this game, and I'm still learning as I go. And I watched a couple of the videos of a couple of the other Bankshot players in the early rounds of this game, and both play the game a little bit differently as far as card turning. That's my biggest worry when you have a set amount of action deck cards, which you have in Bankshot. You want to make sure you get enough possessions and enough field goal attempts per half per team. And these two teams I've got here, 72 UCLA averaged roughly 75 field goal attempts per game, while Michigan State averaged only about 55 field goal attempts per game. So it's just quite a difference there. And that is that difference they try to, Joe Bryan of SSG kind of builds into his pace category. Michigan State's pace is minus five, which typically means you'd subtract five cards from the action deck per every half of half, which is 10 minutes of play. Whereas UCLA they've got a plus six on pace, which means they like to run up the score. UCLA averaged almost 95 points a game in 1972. And therefore, they're, of course, going to be trying to step up the pace all the time. So the first half, I only got about 29 field attempts off for the UCLA Bruins. So I'm going to try and see if I can get... Let me take a quick look here. Actually 13 for 28 from the field. So that's a pace of about 56. They average 75. Against a team like Michigan State, I'd expect them to maybe be in a little higher pace, at least get into the 60s on field goal attempts. But Michigan State's gotten a few offensive rebounds and have been able to do the job and stay in this game despite the foul difficulties. UCLA is relatively foul free. They have two fouls on Greg Lee and two on Keith Wilkes, whereas Michigan State's got a couple guys with three and three guys with two. So a foul here and a foul there, and they could be in trouble because they don't have much depth. I've actually had to resort to playing the Berkovich brothers, and Don didn't hardly play at all. But Mike played quite a bit, so. But I needed a forward, so I threw Don in, and Don did a pretty good job to keep his Spartans in the game. So I'm going to go through this first half, second half, and see what happens, see if UCLA can pick up the pace. I'm going to change a couple of things that I didn't do in the first half as far as saving these action deck cards a little bit when checking for some assists. I might check for the assists and then use the same card for the next possession just to get a couple extra plays in. I also added, I had a net of only plus one card for UCLA. I added three cards to this deck for each half. That's about 73 cards right there. Got a second deck ready for the second half of the second, 10 minutes of the second half. So we'll see how that plays out. And the game so far flows reasonably well, but at the same time, I'm still learning. It's my first half of ball, so you're going to have to learn right along with me. So the first thing we do is we pick a fast break deck. This is one of those new things to me as well. Two decks, one a fast break deck, one an action deck, which determines the amount of plays we're going to have. So let's just say I'm got the jump ball right here, and it's at home team, which I'm giving Michigan State a home court advantage slightly. I'm not obeying all of the special home court features because there's a little reading here, the question mark reading. Some of those have asked, you know, me to give three straight possession baskets to Michigan State, and I'm just not going to do that. I'm not going to do those type of things, and I will limit the amount of injuries as well because I've already got enough foul problems. I'm just trying to get through a game here, so pardon the difference from the actual rules, but it's my game, and I'm going to play it the way I want to. So jump ball goes to the home team. Looks like we're going to get the ball to the center, which is Ron Charles. I'll use this little marker here, and Ron's in foul trouble with three. It says they're going to use the defender column, and that defender is Bill Walton, the best defender on the court. So what we're going to do is going to roll the dice, and that will be 37, just like the start of the regular game. Walton on 37 on the defensive side has a block shot. So that's block shot number 8 for Bill Walton. And I am fully keeping score on my electronic score sheet. It's an NBA style score sheet, so I'm just kind of like making first quarter, first 10 minutes, second quarter, second 10 minutes of the half, third quarter, first 10 minutes of the second half, and so on. So I can at least see how they're doing in a half by half mode. That is the 8th block shot for Bill Walton. I can't remember. I got to go for a rebound. Yeah, let's go for the rebound, which is on the action deck. And it goes defense G2. So the G2 is Henry Bibby. Bibby grabs the board. Now, from JAA's video I saw, I'm not going to turn a card. I'm going to save a little bit of cartage by saying whenever I get a rebound, is that how I was going to do it? I can't remember. Maybe I am going to advance the ball. Well, let's go with this for a few minutes. We're going to go F1 versus defender. So that's going to be Jamal, actually Keith Wilkes at the time. And he's going to go on to Greg Kelser's defender's card. So the red matches up with his red defender's card. And I got a percent chance of 31. And on the 31 on Kelser, it looks like a block shot himself. So Wilkes is blocked by Kelser. And so we're going to go for another rebound. And that's a defensive center with an FB next to it. So that's going to be Charles with the rebound. And it says FB, which means fast break. So turn the fast break card up and it says held up. There are some rating issues between, you know, each team is rated for fast break. Let's see, fast break D. And I think UCLA's defense on the fast break's a minus one. So that's actually an E fast break, which is not very good. UCLA has an A fast break, but they have a defense of minus one. So they're running a B fast break as well. So what did we get? We just got that held up fast break. So Michigan State has the ball. Check our card. It's going to be B3, which is a scoring characteristic. The guys with the B ratings get the ball a little bit more. I have Magic Johnson with a B1 in the upper right corner. I've got Greg Hills with a B2 in the upper right corner. None of those qualify as a B3. So we just go to the G1 and use the defensive center, which, believe it or not, G1, that's guard one. Magic is going up against Big Bill Walton. So let's see what Walton can do in his second defensive try here. 25 and 0 to 45 is a block shot. Ninth block shot for Bill Walton. The big redhead just kicking some butt. Let's go for the rebound. Offense G1. It also says in parentheses, two-pointer. Oh, two-point. Is that 2 points, 2-7? I am not 100% sure on that. Is it a two-point shot or a two-pointer? I am not certain on that. That rebound, the two-pointer is made if you roll a 2-7, and it's a miss otherwise, and that's a D12 die, a 2D6, sorry, and I roll a 7, which means Magic Johnson grabs the rebound, immediately puts the ball back up and scores. So ring one up for Michigan State. And the game's a little bit closer. Now the question is, do I go... Yeah, that was the rebound card, so let's keep moving on. UCLA with the ball. So I don't have a time clock with this. There are game marker cards that separate one-minute increments if you want to use them. But here we go. Bill Walton will have the ball. Big Bill, because it's shaded in green, it'll be his offensive card. And it's a 93. And Walton, 89-99, is fouled. So he's guarded by his defender. That's Ron Charles' fourth foul. Which is not a good thing because they don't have a lot of centers, but I'm at this point where I can't, there's not much I can do about it. So I'm going to play Charles as long as he'll run, and we'll just keep going. First team foul. Once you hit seven team fouls, then it's a one-on-one situation in college back in the day. And I don't even think they even increased it beyond one-on-one after 10 fouls like they did. This is an interesting test because it does not utilize the three-point shot. So I don't have to worry about three-pointers in this game. So I'm liking that because I'm still learning. Okay, here we go. Another one. Center versus defender. Now it's on the defender's card. Ron Charles could foul out on this play. We'll find out using his defensive column, a 46. And I believe he forces a missed shot. All right. Good job, Ron. Missed by Walton. Rebound. Defensive F1 and a fast break. Let's see. Greg Kelser. Running the fast break is pretty simple. You go to the fast break deck. Two-pointer missed, F2. So it went to Jay Vincent on the break. He missed the layup. And we'll go after a rebound again. Defensive goaltending. So that'll actually be a basket by Jay Vincent. So that was a goaltended shot. And Michigan State has pulled this game within two, 35-33. UCLA gets the ball one more time. Going to the G2, it's Henry Bibby. Bibby's the leading scorer in the game. I think he's got about 15 points or so. I'll have to take a look. Bibby, G2. So it's going to be his offensive card shaded. And a roll of 15 on Bibby. And it looks like 0 to 19 basket. And if I was 0 to 10, it'd be an assist, but it's not. So a basket for Henry Bibby. And UCLA is finally on the board in the second half. And each one of these comes out, it's about 7 action deck cards per minute played, and I can kind of estimate the minutes pretty well based on my first half results. So here comes Michigan State. And here's another one where they have the B3 rating. I've got a B1 in Magic. I got a B2 in Kelser, but no B3, so we're going to use the G2. And once again, it'll be his offensive column. That's Terry Donnelly. And a 16 on Donnelly gets him what? It looks like a missed shot. Missed shot for Terry Donnelly. And I think with the newer games, of course, you'd be checking that as a 2-point attempt or a 3-point attempt. Here's the rebound. Defensive F2 fast break. So Larry Farmer. Get a fast break, which is the fast break deck. 2-point basket. F2. So Farmer's got the fast break basket. My fast break rating was D or E. The modified rating will be a B. So it's good. Otherwise, it would have been held up. So Larry Farmer, 2 points. I'm going to even check for an assist on this card for the fun of it. F2 or F1. So we'll give an assist to Wilkes. Farmer, 2. Wilkes with the assist. Touchscreen not working great. 39-33. UCLA. Pops up by 6 one more time. They've kind of been doing that the whole game. They're up by double digits a little bit. Maybe 15-6. Maybe it was a 9-point lead. Anyway, Michigan State comes back down. It's a B1, and we do have a B1 in Magic. But as we see, it's the defender's card because it's shaded. So Greg Lee's defense will be guarding Magic. Hopefully he won't foul him. That's a 40. And that is going to be... Take a look at it. 25-59 miss. That's some good defense. Even though Magic's much bigger. I even had Magic playing some center by the end of the half with the foul problems. That may happen again. So missed shot by Magic. You go after the rebound with the action deck. It's defensive center fast break. So Walton. Run the fast break using the fast break deck. 2-point basket, G1. So Greg Lee scores. So it's now 41-33. I could check for an assist. I'm just going to use the card that's here. Assisted by F1. I'm going to give an assist to Wilkes. But as you can see with that basket, it was pretty arbitrary. It was not any person would have made that basket, whether he was a really good shooter or poor shooter. They're just assuming he had a layup and it was a breakaway and it's good. So hopefully in the end, the accuracy factor or relative accuracy will still work with this game. And still experimenting here with bank shot basketball. Here we go with the return to Michigan State. Well, we got the center. And he is being guarded by the G1, though. So if something happens, we're shooting with the center's offensive card. If he draws a foul, it'll be on Greg Lee. That'll be his third. So Ron Charles, who averaged about 8.8 points per game, is going to go up. And he got an 8. And he's 0-9 turnover. Offensive foul 9-11 with a 2D sixer. Uh-oh. Good. Just a turnover for Ron Charles. Doing an up-to-date score check as the UCLA Bruins take over. Bibby leads all scorers with 15 points on 6 of 11 from the field, 3 of 3 from the free throw line. Walton has 4 rebounds to go with 9 block shots. Not grabbing a lot of boards, but Michigan's very pragmatic about their offense. They don't shoot a lot. Keith Wilkes, just 2 for 7 from the field, struggling a bit. Michigan State is being led by Magic Johnson with 10 points. Just 3 of 9 from the floor, though. Walton keeps blocking his shot, and he's only 4 of 7 from the line, which is uncharacteristic of Magic's, who I think hit about 84% on the year. And let me take a look if I can verify that. I put out 30 envelopes on my own just to get a standard starting lineup for each team, and Magic hit 84.2% from the free throw line. All right. UCLA ball, they're trying to get this lead up even higher. We got an F2 versus defender. F2 is Larry Farmer. But it's going to be Larry's offensive card. He's not a great offensive player. Let's see what he does with 43. 27-68 is a miss. So Larry does not hit there. Check the rebound. Offense, G2. So that's going to be Henry Bibby. And little Henry, if I can get a 2-7, we'll have a basket. And he puts it in, Henry Bibby. Once again, another arbitrary result. Henry Bibby's not really that great of an offensive rebounder. Of course, this game was created with the lack of statistics for a lot of players in this era. I think they might have had offensive rebounding for Michigan State, but they certainly did not have offensive rebounding in 1972 for UCLA. So there's a lot of ratings there. Bibby's rating in the offensive boards is only 6, so that's going to be a rare play that he'll actually get an offensive rebound and score. Back to Michigan State. They need something, need some offense. G2 versus defensive F1. So Donnelly ran into a little mismatch here with Jamal Wilkes at F1 using Wilkes' defensive card, and Wilkes can play some pretty good defense. Got a 6 on Wilkes' defense. And it looks like Wilkes fouled him while shooting, though. So, here we go. Just put down Wilkes. He's going to get the foul. Now we must determine whether Terry Donnelly makes the shot or not. He has a yellow column in the middle where he sinks the shot on. Looks like 0-38 and a 2-point miss on 39 and higher. So, he makes it. He gets a basket and a chance for a 3-point play. And it's a 38 right on the nose. So Donnelly scores. Cuts the lead to 8. He is fouled. He gets 1 free throw. And we'll see his free throw column is along the left side, 71. Well, it says 68-77 is a 2-8 opportunity. So we roll the 2 die, 2d6s, and it's a 7. 3-point play, Terry Donnelly. really good role player on that championship team of 1979 with Magic. All right, back to live action with UCLA. There's a B2. UCLA does not feature any B2 players, so it'll probably be an F2 player, which would be Larry Farmer. And so Farmer's going to go up with a shot on the Defenders card. That'd be Jay Vincent's defensive column. And that's a 56. Block shot by Jay and miss by Farmer. Got to go for the rebound. Loose ball foul. Well, I guess we do another one for the loose ball foul. Offensive center. Okay, that's going to be on Bill Walton. That's two on Bill. I like going to a second card, so it's not going to always be the same result. Having said that, I'm going to use the same card to get the next play started. We're just going to go F2. Jay Vincent over here, offensive column for Jay, and it's a 22 on Jay. Let's see, 7 to 49 is a miss on Jay. Rebound, loose ball foul again. Holy cow! Defensive center, two quick fouls on Walton. And now he has three fouls. Three team fouls on UCLA. This is getting kind of dangerous. Both Charles and Walton. Well, Charles, of course. But let's stick with this center versus defensive F2. So we're going to have Charles guarded by Farmer. And it's going to be Charles going up. Oops. Fast break number 63. .38-68 is a basket for Ron Charles. Michigan State creeps in closer. Now it says assist 38-52. It would have been an assist if that number would have been in that range, but it wasn't, so we don't give an assist to that play. Five-point game. F2, we're going right back to Larry Miller. Miller's going to use his offensive card. Let's see what we get. 0-2, what does that mean? Basket. And it says assist from 0 to 12, so there will be an assist. So Farmer checks in with a hoop. And the assist will go to the next card. Assisted by F2 or G1. Well, he is the F2, so give the assist to Lee. All right. Here comes Michigan State. Oh, I'm going to use the same card since I was just checking for an assist. F2 versus Defender. F2, that's J. But we're using Farmer's card. So what do we got? A 29. 29 is a foul on Farmer. That gives Larry two fouls and 14 fouls, non-shooter. Michigan State retains possession. There you go, F2. F2 is going to be Jay again, but it's going to be you-know-who. What does change steal? Change steal the two-point basket. Oh. Well, if I was stealing the ball, is that what they're talking about? We'll find out. It's going to go up on Walton's defensive card. Does Walton get a four? Block shot by Bill one more time. That's double-digit blocks for Walton. Another block for Bill, rebounded by. Neil, rebound's going to go to the defensive F1 in a fast break, so Wilkes clears the board. Fast break upcoming. Basket, G1, but held up if it's B to E. Michigan State turns the A fast break into a B, so it is held up, unfortunately, for the Bruins. Let's see what we got here. I think I'm going to just, let's see, that was a fast break card. Let's start another play. That's good. Oh, a C. But it's got a plus, a question mark. So I think I complete the play first and then I check on the question mark. So let's just do that. Got a 73 for Bill. And 66 to 88 is a basket. And it's also an assist on the play. So let's see how that works out. Assist on the play. We'll check that out real quickly. G2 or G1. We'll just go with G2, Bibby. And we will check out the question mark. We'll see what the result is. B1, B2, or F2 on team auto rolls his basket result on the next three possessions. Now, that's too complex for me at this stage of my first game. So that just shows you the type of complexity you can have in bank shot basketball. But I'm just going to kind of ignore that for now. I just really want to just play through and not have to keep such detailed stuff while I'm doing a video here. Center versus defensive G1. Charles going up on Greg Lee's card. That's an 80 on Lee. Defensively. 68 to 99. He allows a basket. So it looks like a basket for Charles and an assist as well. Wait, 80? Yes. Basket, Charles. Assist on the play as well. F2 or G2, we'll go with Jay Vincent. And it's 47 to 40. Big basket by Ron Charles, who put about 8.8 points a game in. And tonight, he has got 6 points. All right. Back to UCLA. We're just going to use this because we had to check for an assist. Let's just use this number, the B2, not available for UCLA. F1 goes to Wilkes. Wilkes having a tough time from the floor. Gets a 91. And he turns it over. Could be an offensive foul if I rolled a 9. It's an 8. Just a turnover for Wilkes. His offensive woes continue. Here comes Michigan State. F1 versus defensive G1. So ball goes to Kelser, but we're going to use the defense of Greg Lee one more time. Oops. Put that in the wrong place. And that's an 05 on Greg Lee's defense. Turnover, steal by Greg Lee. It says steal 2-9. On his card right there. So it was a great defensive play by Lee. Turnover for Gregory Kelser. Steal for Lee. That gives you the option to fast break if you just get a steal like that. So let's give it a shot because it's UCLA. It says C to E held up. We are a modified B. So it's a 2-point basket for the F1. Jamal Wilkes. You can see the strength of the fast break leading to easy baskets in this game. And let's see. Is there an assist on that play? Let's just check it. and it's going to be G2 or G1. We'll give it to Bibby. Once again, I will stick with this card because that was just an assist check. And B3 on Michigan State does not exist, but we do have a center, and the defender is Walton. You think with 10 blocks, they'd be up by more than 10 points, but Michigan State's obviously a difficult opponent. Let's see, 51 on Walton. -54 is a turnover, and it's a steal if I get a 7 through 12, and I do. So, turnover, Charles. Steal Walton. We're going to go another fast break. UCLA's fabled fast break. Fast break, double A to E held up, so that will not be a fast break. And here comes UCLA. F1. Back to Keith Wilkes. And Wilkes is going to fire it on his offensive column. 17. Well, 0 to 24 is a basket. And no assist. Basket Wilkes. So UCLA is now up 51 to 40. Showing their dominance. They were 30-0 in the years, I recall. Oh, 30-2, perhaps? Not sure. Some of these records on the bank shot are not correct on the cards. Ball goes to the G1. Goes to Magic. Versus defender. So it's going to be Greg Lee being tested at the defensive end again. A 96 on Lee. Missed shot. Good defense. So, Magic just 1-for-4 this half. Rebound is going to go to defensive center. Bill gobbles up another one. And we'll just, let's see. I'm going to stay with this card, actually, I think. Or do I? Is that assist check, rebound check? Oh heck, we'll turn the card on this one. I'm not sure. I'm being inconsistent. B2, F2. Looks like Farmer. It's gonna go up. That's a 15. Basket assist 0-12. No basket for Farmer. And suddenly Michigan State has stalled on offense. Michigan State gets the ball back, F1. Ball goes to Kelser. And Kelser's going to 65, draws the foul. And that is a foul on Bill Walton. And that'll be number 4 on Bill. That is the 5th team foul, and we may have to make a substitution to get Bill out of there really quickly. He's quite valuable to UCLA. Alrighty, Sven Nader has checked in. Played a lot in the NBA, was Bill Walton's backup at UCLA, so he'll be at the center. Here comes Michigan State. B1. Magic Man, defender, Greg Lee. Let's find out what Greg can do. That's a 57. And looks like another missed shot. Yep, good defense by Lee. Holding the Magic Man in check. Rebound. Defensive F1 fast break, Wilkes. Fast break card coming up. 2-point basket for if our... Oh, yeah. Only if your fast break is E. So, 2-point basket, B1 or B2. Oh, we have no B1s or B2. So it doesn't look like we get a fast break. I'm going to count that as like a held up. You need a guy who can really score the ball. So even though UCLA runs a good fast break, they have no B1s or B2s. Continue the possession here. F1 versus defender. It's Greg Kelser playing the defense. And it's a 41. Ooh. Foul while shooting? No. Did I get that right? No, 41. Oh, it's a block shot. All right. Had some troubles with my computer there. But let's see. Let's grab a rebound off that block shot. Rebound defense G1. That's me magic. So Magic has the ball. And B2 is going to get the ball. That's going to be Greg Kelser. But it's going to be the defensive center, which is now Swen Nader, 68. A block by Nader. Walton leaves and the block party continues. Rebounded by Hyatt, F2. Hyatt, F2. And that's a 28 for Farmer. Offensive rebound, a 33 for Vincent. So Vincent will keep the ball in play for Michigan State. Michigan State with possession. Center versus defensive F1. So it's Charles versus the defensive Wilkes. Jamal gets a 42. And it's a missed shot for Charles. And a missed shot rebounded by defense F1 again. That's going to be Wilkes' fast break. Fast break card held up. All right. What I was just going to say is the bank shot basketball has its own set of dice that come with the game as well. So if I wanted to play this game without utilizing randomized numbers, say the dice numbers or the 2d6 or the single d6 numbers, I could do that as well. But we're trying the cards today, kind of give you that status pro basketball old school feel. And let's see what Michigan State can do now that they're down by whole load of points, 13, but Walton does have 4 fouls. Ball's going to G1. That's the Magic Man. Magic Man's going to go up. 60 on Magic Johnson. Yeah, 47 to 61's a basket, so count it for Irv and Magic Johnson. No assist. UCLA comes back. It's going to go to the B1. They don't have any B1s in the lineup. But they got a C, which is Big Swen. Swen Nader. Oops, why did I put it over there? I keep doing that. Big Swen. 34. And that's a basket. And no assist. So Big Swen Nader's come in, delivered a block shot and a two-pointer. And UCLA's maintaining the lead. Here we go. F2, defensive F1, though. And that's Jay Vincent. but he is defended by the F1 Jamal Wilkes. Now, I've noticed in this game so far, there's been a lot of defensive switches on a lot of plays. And you know what? It almost makes sense for the college game where they play a lot of zone, pay a lot of matchups zones, you know, a 3-2 or a 2-3 or whatever the heck they play as in sets. So you're not always facing up against your defender. This one's going to be Keith Wilkes. 14 on his defensive column, and he's 10 to 43, forces a missed shot for Vincent. Rebound. Offensive F1, so that's going to be Greg Kelcer. Michigan State retains. Hands the ball off to the G2, Terry Donnelly. Donnelly, defensive F2. That's Larry Farmer. And 13. On defense is 8 to 23 turnover. So they force the turnover. Donnelly gives it right back to UCLA. G2 versus defender. Bibby versus Donnelly. Donnelly's defense, 16, 6 to 42 missed by Bibby. Goes the rebound. Offensive center is going to grab a Swen. The Dutchman keeps the ball in play. Ball goes F1. Wilkes, who's had a rough shooting night, versus the defensive center of Charles. He's got to dodge the foul problems. It's 47. Ooh, 48 would have been a foul. Missed shot by Wilkes. Rebound. Hyatt, F1 offensive guy, gets a D6. So I got to remember to do that. Let's see. Hyatt, F1. Wilkes has a 30. Kelcer has a 36. So even if the 6 was a 6, you give it to the defensive rebounder. They tied at 36 plus a D6. Kelcer with the rebound. Ball goes to the G2. Donnelly guarded by his defender. And we got a 60. And a 60 on Donnelly's card is a foul. So Bibby picks it up. It's actually 16 fouls. Just the first on Bibby, though. So, non-shooter. He's just fouled. Everything else will be a 1-1, unless it's a shooting foul. Spartans. Oops, wrong card. As I'm just not used to having two FAC decks. Center goes to Ron Charles. Charles is going to go up. 83. And that's a missed shot by Ron. Ron 2 for 4 in this half. Rebound. Offense F2. So Vincent will grab that board. Sets it back up for the Spartans. G2. Ball goes to Donnelly. Oh, we did that again. Donnelly. /74. Assist for Donnelly. First basket in a few plays. The points are going to go to... Scorer on assist is F2, Jay Vincent. And let's check the scoring. Vincent now has double digits with 10. The big news, however, is Greg Kelcer is 0 for 4. He has 0 points, and Kelcer led the team in scoring average at 18.8. So Jamal Wilkes has done a heck of a job on Kelcer. Other scorers... 12 for Magic, 7 for Donnelly. And that was his first assist. UCLA is still led by Henry Bibby with 17 on the game. 9 each for Wilkes, Farmer, and Walton. UCLA shooting 51.1% from the field, 40.4% from the free throw line. And 40.4 is what Michigan State's shooting from the field. They're shooting 75% from the free throw line. Michigan State's even struggling at the foul line, 545, and only 40.4 from the floor. So there's what's going on right now. So back to UCLA. We still got a little stack of cards here left for the first 10 minutes. Seems like we're getting some shots off this time. Like I said, I'm kind of not turning as many on certain assist checks and things, so. Or maybe I shouldn't have done that there then. No, whatever. We'll just do this. Greg Lee versus defender, so it's going to be Magic Johnson's defense. Let's see what he can do. 79 forces the turnover. The D6 does not give him the steal, though. Turnover for Lee. Here comes Michigan State. F1 defender card. And that's going to be Greg Kelser, but using the great defense of Wilkes. Oh, whoops. Got to find the random number. It's a 95. Ooh, and Wilkes fouled him. And that's the fourth foul on Wilkes. That's also the seventh team foul of the half, which means Wilkes is on the borderline of fouling out. Kelser's going to get a 1-1. Free throw attempt is a 26, and it's good. He earns the second one, gets a 13, and it's good. F2. And defense is G2. F2 is going to be Larry Farmer. Farmer with the ball. Goes up on his offensive card with a 23 miss shot. Rebound. Offense G2. Terry Donnelly. No, wrong. Henry Bibby. Bibby keeps the ball, hands it off to, keeps the ball, G2 versus defensive center, but he is going to have the offensive option here. That's a 75 turnover, and it's an offensive foul if I got an 11 or 12. No. Turnover, Bibby. Haven't had a lot of offensive fouls in this game, so that's kind of an interesting development. Maybe none. G1. Magic with the ball. And Magic's going to go up on his offensive card. He gets a 50. And that's going to be a basket. And he's assisted. This is a closer game than we think. Still plenty of time left in this half. We're going to check for the assist, and we'll use this card on the next play. It's going to be assisted by F2. And that's going to be Jay. So we're going to go G1 versus defender. And once again, Greg Lee's going to fire away. Whoops, wrong card. Greg Lee, 78. That's a missed shot for Lee. Rebounded by defensive F1. That's going to be Greg Kelser. Hanging in there with his three fouls. Center. Ron Charles playing with the four fouls. Defender's going to be Sven Nader. And Nader's going to do a 98 on him, which is a foul. Sven Nader. So, eighth team foul. 1-1 for Ron Charles. And I got a 72, which is going to be a miss. Rebound, loose ball, foul. And that's going to be on the offensive F1. Wow. Greg Kelser just picked up his fourth foul. I just hexed the heck out of Greg Kelcer right there. So, four fouls on Kelcer, UCLA ball, non-shooter. And we're going to just use this card right here because it was just a foul check. Center versus defense of G2. Nader versus the defense of Terry Donnelly. And that's a 40 on the Donnelly defense, forces a miss by Nader. And the rebound is going to go to the offensive center. Nader grabs his own board. So Nader grabs it, hands it off to the G2 versus defensive center. Bibby versus Charles on defense. And an 88. Foul number 5 on Charles. A dreaded foul. Henry Bibby did the job, getting Charles to hack him. 5 fouls and a disqualification with 10 minutes to play in this game. Alrighty, 10 minutes to play. Keith Wilkes has been removed from the game. First appearance by Larry Holyfield at the F2 slot. Larry Farmer moves over to the F1. Tommy Curtis comes in to give Henry Bibby a break. Walton returns for UCLA. See if they can hang on to a 55-48 lead. 7-point deficit for the Spartans. Okay, let's see what happens. B1, G2. Okay, G2. The old Tommy Curtis gets an 85. And that looks like an assist for Tommy Curtis right there. Beautiful pass. Curtis with the assist. Scorer on assist is F2, which will be Larry Holyfield. So 57-48 lead for UCLA. Center versus defender. Got Rob Gonzalez in there, the freshman. Not exactly the best backup, but we'll just do it. He's really a forward, but we're out of centers on this Michigan State team. I don't think they have one more than one true center. The defender's Walton, just back in the game. Got a 61. And 60-93 forces the miss on Gonzalez. Walton, truly a defensive force today with his double-digit block number. And so it's forced miss, rebound's going to go high at center. Well, Walton is a master. He's got a 40 on the defensive boards, a D6 for the Gonzalez. It's not going to matter. Walton offensive automatic re. And you must be asking, how many rebounds does Bill have today? Not as many as you think. He's up to 6 rebounds. That's enough. That's behind Keith Wilkes, who has 8. Even Henry Bibby has 7. So interesting stats there on the boards. UCLA collectively has tied them with 27-27 on the boards so far. Holyfield being defended by the G1. That's Magic Johnson on defense. And that's a 4. And that is a foul on Magic. So that's 4 team fouls, 3 on Madge, and UCLA will continue with the ball. Goes to the F2, that's Holyfield once again. Holyfield's going up, 62. Basket, nice job by Holyfield, and an assist. Holyfield comes in, 2 quick baskets. Let's check the assist on that one. That is going to be F2 or G2. We'll give it to Curtis. Second assist since returning to the game. Good job by Curtis and Holyfield. 11-point lead for UCLA. Spartans throw the ball into Gonzalez one more time, defended by the G2. That's a 9 on Gonzalez. Basket and an assist. Let's see. Assisted by G1 or G2. G2 is Donnelly. We'll go with Donnelly. So it was an assist check, so I'm just going to use this same card. G1, Greg Lee. Lee, with less than 10 minutes to go, goes up. Whoops, wrong card. 44. He's fouled. So he's fouled by the F1, which is Kelser, and that's all for Greg today. Oh, that's unfortunate. That's the fifth team foul, and Kelser must leave the game. UCLA retains possession. Magic Johnson moves up to the forward slot. High assist man goes in the G1 slot, so Donnelly slides in over there. And we got about roughly 8 minutes to go. And UCLA's hanging on to that 9-point lead. They still have the ball, and they're leading the assist parade, 18 to 10. That's one key stat. Both have 9 turnovers. UCLA's hitting 50% from the field. G1. And the G1 is going to be Greg Lee. Lee's going to go for the 91. And that's a missed shot for Lee. Rebound. Offensive center, Walton. Another board for Bill. Ball goes to the G2. But they're playing Rob Gonzalez on the defensive end. I don't know how this is going to work out. 12. Missed shot. So Curtis, no good. Rebound again. Defensive G2. That's going to be Berkovich. Defensive board. Berkovich back into the game as I move Magic up to the front line. Here comes Michigan State. F2. Madge. Give me his offensive card. Let's see what we got. 89. Missed shot by Magic. Not a great day for Magic Johnson. Rebound high at G2. Well, let's see. You got a 22 for Curtis. Yeah, Tommy Curtis will clear. Good rebounding guard. UCLA. G2 versus defender, so that's Curtis. Defender's Berkovich. And what does Berkovich do on defense? 37. That is a foul while shooting. So Curtis, we go to the shooting column, see if he can make the shot. The foul will be on Mike Berkovich. Get that in there. That's the 16th foul. Is the shot good? 31. And he's 0 to 31, so the shot is good by Curtis. Kind of like that mechanism there. Very status pro-y. And Berkovich fouled him on the play, so one free throw for Tommy. And that's a 97, which is pretty much a miss in everybody's book. So Curtis cannot complete the three-point play. Rebound is going to be defensive center. They say fast break. Gonzalez playing out of position. Fast break is basket. G1, but that's only a fast break. B to E held up. So it looks like a hole held up. Michigan State does not run the ball all that often. Their fast break offense is a D. So here comes Michigan State. Whoops, wrong card. I'm getting there. I'll figure this out. F1. J. J's going to have the ball. He's going to go up. And that's a 73 fouled while shooting. So that'll be Larry Farmer's foul. And that gives him 3. And that's at least 9 team fouls, but it doesn't matter. We got to determine if the shot is good by Jay Vincent, and he's a 0-35 on the 2-point shot. 22, good, Vincent. Hits the shot. 61-52, he's going to have one free throw to try to cut this lead down to 8. And Jay gets an 80. And it's not good. A lot of missed free throws here in this half. Rebound on that's going to go to High in game. Well, I would guess that would be Bill Walton. I could be wrong. But I'm looking at everybody's rebounding abilities, and yes, I'm correct. Walton. So Bill's at 9 points, 8 rebounds, and 10 block shots. He should have a triple-double if he does not foul out of this game. And maybe I just threw the whammy on him. That's a G1. Let's run the play plus the crazy weird question mark. So let's see what happens with Greg Lee firing away. That's a 91. And a 91 is a miss by Lee. And what do I do? Do I play the question mark next? Or do I just... Let's grab a rebound first. Defensive F1. Fast break. Vincent. Let's do the fast break, then we'll see what happened. I don't know what I'm doing here. 2-point basket, but no, it's held up because their fast break is not good enough. So let's do a question mark here. Away team called for non-shooting foul in next 2 possessions. I'm just going to ignore that. We're just going to give the ball to Michigan State. I got to get this game moving along. Magic with the ball, but it's the defensive guard. Tommy Curtis is going to try to play Magic. 68 on the defensive end. Good defense. Another miss by Magic. Yeah, Magic is just 5 for 15. Rebound. High on the home team. So that would be high offensive rebound. Jay Vincent has a 33. And he easily grabs that board. Ball in play, G2. That's going to be Berkovich. And defender is Tommy Curtis. UCLA's been playing some pretty good defense. 51, Curtis fouled him. 2-1-on-1. So 1-and-1 for Berkovich. Makes the first, he gets another one. So 70. I need a 7-12. Yes, he makes the first. Berkovich, 17, makes them both. Cuts that lead to 7. In modern day, we'd have a couple three-pointers, and this would be a close game. But in the era of the 2-point shot only, there's a little bit of breathing room for UCLA. Here comes the forward. Whoop. Yeah. Forward. Farmer, F1. Yeah, let's see what he's going to do. Farmer's got a 96. Draws the foul on Donnelly. So that is going to be 7 team fouls, and Farmer's going to get 1-and-1 despite not being a very good foul shooter. What is Farmer? Take a look at that. 549. A 15 is good, though. That'll work any day of the week. 65, 6-12. I need a 6-12. Yes! 2d6, 6-12 works. Farmer gets it. UCLA back up by 9. Here comes a G1. Donnelly with the ball. He's going to fire away. And that's a 32. Miss shot by Donnelly. Guy does not shoot too often. Rebounded by defensive center, Big Bill Walton. 9 points, 9 boards, 12 blocks. Running the fast break for UCLA. Held up. Here comes the center versus Rob Gonzalez on defense. Well, it's actually Walton's ball. Just going to use Rob Gonzalez's defensive column. 84, basket. And no assist. Bill Walton. Double digits in points with 11. 12 block shots, 9 rebounds, looking for that elusive triple-double, and an 11-point lead over the Spartans. Donnelly, with the ball, what's he going to do? Let's find out. 71, assist to Terry Donnelly. Very steady player, Terry Donnelly. Basket, center, Gonzalez. Gonzalez is 3 for 4 on the day. It's back down to 9. Here comes UCLA, G2. Tommy Curtis. 49 for Curtis. That's a missed shot for Tommy. Rebound. High at F1. Well, Farmer has a 29. Jaylee has a 21, so Farmer will grab the offensive board. I love rebound battles. It's always those automatic ones, but those battles make the difference in how many boards these guys are going to get per game. And I flipped the wrong card. Okay, B1, G2. Back to Curtis. What's Curtis going to do with it? It's a 57. Missed shot by Tom. Tommy's shooting a little too much. We will get Bibby back in there very quickly. Rebound. Out of bounds awarded to the away team, which is a team rebound for UCLA. Ball goes to D2. It's Curtis one more time, but it's Berkovich's defense. 59. Turnover, and it's a steal if it's a 4-6. No turnover, Berkovich. Michigan State, I don't believe, has more than one steal today. All right. Well, we're about halfway through this second half. I'm going to make a change here and get Wilkes and Bibby back in. Okay, we're back into the game. I took Farmer out as well. Wilkes returns. Bibby returns for Lee. Curtis will move over to the point guard. Hopefully he'll just pass and not shoot so much. Here comes the B1. And that is the Magic Man. Magic's going to do some razzle-dazzle for a turnover. Oh, if I got a 10... it would have been an offensive foul. Okay, good. Okay, I got to remember to read that properly. Turnover, Madge. Not having a great half. Philadelphia, UCLA's defense is pretty suffocating. Larry Holyfield, defender is Magic. Let's see what Magic Johnson can do. 76 forces a turnover. And 6-12. No. Ah, would have been a steal. Turnover, Holyfield. Oops, wrong way. Here comes Michigan State. B3. And Kelser's out, so it's the G2. Going to Mike Berkovich. Burke shoots, 72. Miss. Rebound. Offense F2. Magic Johnson. gets it. Back to the F1. Jay, Defender's card. Jamal, 82. Missed shot. 83 would have been a turnover, so Jay just misses. And the Michigan State's still shooting close to 40% from the field. Rebound. Hyatt, G2. Offense added E6. So Hyatt, G2. Bibby's not very good. 17. Berkovich, you get a D6. And the D6 gives me a 2, which is not going to give him more than 15. Bibby does clear another rebounding. Having a great rebounding game. I believe that is 8 boards for Henry. And we're going over to Holyfield. Holyfield's going to take it to the rack. That's a 41. Misfires. Pretty good shooting mechanic overall here. Rebound. Defensive G1. That's going to be Terry Donnelly. Donnelly with the ball for State. Gets the ball to the B2. No, G2. Berkovich on his own. Fires away 59. And that's going to be a missed shot by Berkovich. They could sure use Kelser right now, even though Kelser fouled out without scoring a point. That's the story of the game so far. Rebound. Going to be a loose ball foul. Well, Michigan State trying to make a late charge. Here they go. F1 defender. It's Magic Johnson over Keith Wilkes. And that's a 49 on Wilkes. And that's going to be a foul on Wilkes. He just came back and he picks up his 5th foul. Wilkes leaves the game. And coming back into the game is Larry Farmer. So they got Larry and Larry on the front line. 2 shots for Magic Johnson. Trying to cut into this lead. That's a 93, and that is not good. Oh, 3-6. No, Magic continues to struggle from the line. And a 34 makes the 2nd. '65-'58. Players are starting to foul out. Center, Bill Walton. Doesn't get the ball too much. 15? It says 11-39 missed, so that's a missed shot for Bill. Rebound. Hyatt, F2. F2, Farmer. Offensive 29. Defensive 21. Farmer with the offensive board. UCLA retains possessions. It's a guard. Bibby. Bibby's going to be firing away. Let's see what he's got. A 57. Missed shot by Bibby. UCLA down to 44%. Michigan State still at 40%. Rebound high at G1 now. Donnelly has an 11. And Curtis has an 11. So defense, Donnelly. F2 defender. That's going to be Jay. Vincent defender is Farmer. What's Farmer going to do? That's a 53. And that's a basket. Jay Vincent scores. It's a 5-point game. And that's a 53. Trying to figure out. Got a 53 in the defender's card. And it's 32-43 would have been an assist. So it's 65-60. Comes UCLA. G1. Tommy Curtis. 41. Misfire by Curtis. Curtis has got to stop shooting. Rebound. Offensive F2. Two-pointer, 2-8, and it goes in. So F2 is going to be Farmer. And Farmer goes up. Scores! Larry Farmer! Huge basket. Ball in the right place in the right time. F2 versus defense of G1. Jay guarded by Curtis. Can Curtis come through on defense? 47. Basket. This is 20-33. No. So, F2, Vincent scores. Quite a charge right here at the end by the Michigan State Spartans. Center versus defender. It's going to be Gonzalez. Defending Big Bill Walton, 27. Missed shot. Good defense by Gonzalez. Rebound high at F2. Offensive gets a D6. Well, it looks like the offense is going to get this one anyway because Larry Farmer's got a 29 on the offensive board. Farmer coming through once again. Ball goes to the F2. It's going to be Farmer. Farmer, defender again. So Farmer, Jay Vincent, gets a 69. Basket and an assist. More clutch play by Larry Farmer. Assist goes to G1 or G2 will go Tommy Curtis. Finally doing something positive for UCLA. And that may have put it out of reach. We don't know. We got a few cards left, though. You never know. There's no three-point shots. So we'll just use the G2 here because I use that for assist check. Berkovich, defender. Bibby on the defensive end, 46. Turnover. Turnover for Berkovich. Is it a steal from 5 to 12? Yes, steal by Bibby. Going to run the fast break with the UCLA Bruins. Two-point basket. Fast break DE held up. It is a two-point basket for Larry Holyfield. .71-62. I will check for an assist. F1, G1 will go to Curtis. 71-62. Here's the F1. Magic hasn't had a good game. 52. He scores and there's an assist. Magic finally comes through. 71-64. Assist goes to F1 or G2. It's going to be Berkovich. We'll stay with this card. G1, Curtis, going up against his defender, and that, whoops, wrong card. 40, Curtis. That's a miss. Curtis is just a brick machine. I should get Lee back in, but we're running out of time. Let's see what happens here. Rebound. Hyatt, G1, home plus 10. Hyatt, G1. Well, home plus 10. His 11 is a 21, and that'll give Donnelly the board. F2J, defensive center Walton, 25, blocked by Bill Walton. Miss by Jay. Block 13 by Bill, I believe. Rebounded by defensive F2 fast break. That's Farmer. Who's played a great stretch of ball. Fast break. Offensive foul G2. That's Bibby. Turnover and offensive foul. And that's three on Bibb. Here comes. G1 versus Defender. Donnelly. Has the ball. 76. Assist, Donnelly. '71, '66. Basket goes to G2, Brookovich. It's a 5-point lead with just a few cards to go. Oh, we'll just read off this. B1, F2, it's going to be Farmer, oh, wrong card. Farmer, 43. Missed shot by Farmer. It is a 5-point game, but is it too little too late? Rebound, defensive F1, Magic. Fast break. Basket, G2, but if it's a D or E, held up. Michigan State's already at E, so that's held up. It's too bad, because they needed that desperately. That's a B1, Magic. Magic, 6. Turnover, Magic Johnson. It's too bad. And finally, G1, Curtis, Defender card. Dice roll of 1. Foul while shooting. Donnelly's going to get the foul. And the shot by Curtis is a 0. It's good, Tommy Curtis. You're missing at least 5-4 in a row. Makes it. Makes the shot. And the foul. Donnelly, one more free throw. Is a 31. And it's good. And there's your final, UCLA 74, Michigan State 66. Quite a game. Looking at the stat lines tonight, UCLA 449 from the field, hit 31 of 69 shots, 12 of 16 free throws, 11 turnovers, 13 blocks. I've only got 11 recorded here for Big Bill Walton. For some reason, I thought he had more. Either way, Walton does finish the game one rebound short of that triple-double, 11 points, 9 rebounds, 11 blocks. Henry Bibby, 17 points, and 8 rebounds of all things. He also got himself 4 assists. Larry Farmer had a strong second half, finishing the game with 15 points on 6 for 12 shooting, and he also grabbed 8 rebounds. Looking at the side for Michigan State, they ended up shooting actually 429 from the field, not too far off, 27 of 63. Couldn't make a free throw, 12 of 21. They did have 13 turnovers, only 1 steal, and 3 block shots. They were led by Magic Johnson's 17 points. I don't have the minutes in there. He actually played, I think, the whole game, 40 minutes. And 11 rebounds, 4 assists, 6 of 16, only 5 of 9 from the line, uncharacteristic. He had 11 rebounds. There's not much else on this stat line. Jay Vincent had a good second half, threw in 16 points, had 5 rebounds. And Greg Kelser, he did actually finish with 2 points. He made 2 free throws, so he did not get shut out, but he fouled out in 23-ish minutes or so and did not have a very good game. Good defense by Keith Wilkes, who ended up shooting just 4 of 11 and 1 of 1 from the line, but did play great defense throughout. Team percentages, I got a little bit here, I think. It's UCLA. The halves went this way, 35 to 29 at halftime. UCLA outscored them 39-37 in the second half. Rebounds were very even, 36-37. Assists, UCLA 20 to 13. 5-1 on steals and 13-3 on blocks. They led in all of those categories. So anyway, that's the kind of game we had today. Opening game of you know, bank shot basketball. A lot of a learning curve here to be done. It actually flows pretty well once you get it down, but I'm still learning to navigate the two sets of fast action cards at the same time. You know, I'm just kind of fascinated when I look at the game board here, and it just shows the G1s and the F1s and the F2s. This is from 1974, and that's Status Pro NBA Players Association game. I see some similarities here. This is off, you know, just the same type of thing from 50 years ago. And also, I would say, as for the multiplayer board, I would probably not advise that for the college game, because there's just not a lot of depth on these teams. They're not making substitutions too much. Maybe it would work, but I just don't think it would be the advisable unless you're playing maybe some NBA with some teams that actually have some depth on them. So anyway, cool board, but I'm not going to use it for college. And once again, I'm going to mention the dice. You got the four dice, you got the two 10-sided, you got the two D6s, and they'd come in handy. I don't know if the results would be any faster if I just started rolling the dice, but that'll be another way to play the game in addition to the fast break deck. So anyway, this has been a game of UCLA 74, Michigan State 66. Thanks for watching, and thanks for tuning in to Rod's Tabletop Hoops.